Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. In this video we are going to see how we can use this IRF520 MOSFET, a switch with Arduino, to control a high current load or a bulb like this, or to control a high current motor like this. You can get the code for this project by clicking at the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. This is the module. We have two pins here for the load. They have been labeled as plus, V minus. So we'll connect your load, motor, whatever you want to turn on. But of course, it should be DC. And this is the ground and V, and this will be connected to your power supply. There are three pins here, two are used, so this is ground, and that is signal. So this will be connected to pin 8 in this application, and this will be connected to the ground. The space that they left for the heatsink is very minimal, and you cannot install a proper heatsink here. Length of this module is 33.6 millimeters. The width is 25.6 millimeters. And the height without any heat sink at the current condition is about 2 centimeters or 20 millimeter. If you want to know the weight of this module, 7.2 grams. Now let's have a look at the data sheet. There are many manufacturers are producing this. Drain source voltage or power supply that you can use would be up to 100 volts. So the drain source, between this drain and that source, resistance here when gate source is 10 volt is 0.27 ohm, so 270 milliohm. So the pins are from left gate drain source. At 25 degrees temperature, 9.2 ampere. This can, of course, it needs heat sink. This is a drain current, but if it reaches to 100 degrees Celsius, gets very hot, then it can handle up to 6.5 ampere. Here is another data sheet for this IRF52N. This is from International Rectifier. And the resistance of drain source when it's on, this one is 200 milliohm, and the drain current is 9.7 ampere. The characteristics of changed a little here. So you see pulse current, if it just momentarily comes, it can handle up to 38, but this is again 9.7 and 6.8 ampere, the same thing at 25 degrees and 100, so they're very close. I've drawn it quickly on Eagle. Here is a schematic diagram. This is the MOSFET, and we have drain and source. The load that you put will be connected between the positive and the drain. So the current comes here and goes, and this acts as a switch to connect this to the ground. This way it will be connected to the ground. And then the gate here, the gate has, the signal comes this way, and we have a 1 kilo ohm resistor to the ground. So it's always low, even if it's low or high. So this will keep it low if it's not connected. And then we have 1 kilo ohm and an LED. So when there is a signal, the LED will go on. And remember, because Arduino goes with a high, it goes up to 5 volts. So this is the gate and source. So these will never be above 5 volts. And for that reason, because the gate source resistance, the drain source resistance of this MOSFET is 0.2 or 200 ohm or 270 ohm, depending on the type. If it is 10 volts, so when gate source is 10 volts, then we have lower resistance. If gate source is lower, then this will be higher. For that reason, we will see a huge voltage drop here. So if this is 12 volts, this will act as a switch to connect, but we have some voltage drop here. Keep that in mind when you use this module. Now let's have a look at the code. I've defined pin 8 for the controlling the MOSFET, so I call it 8, so I will use throughout this code the keyword control because it's the defined. And then here we say pin mode control, which is 8 as an output. And inside the setup, this is the only thing that we do. And inside the loop, we digital write control high, so we turn on the motor and then wait for 2 seconds and then turn off, set it low and wait for 2 seconds. So this loop is like that. Of course for your application it might be different. For example, if you're controlling a load based on temperature, pressure, some action, some motion, you will say if you put your condition here, if something is true, then you will turn the, based on whatever condition you put here, let's say the temperature, and temperature is a variable, temp is greater than 30, then this should start the motor running, or a pump that is pushing a liquid, whatever. Then you can put here else, if that condition does not meet, then it should be off. And then also you can remove this, because let's say for this condition you want continuously the motor to be running or the switch to be on. Doesn't have to be motor, so whatever is your application, this way you can control your load with this switch. The question is, why do we need this one? Why should we use this module? The answer is that this module, the Arduino, can supply very little current. This from USB, some machines or computers can supply 500 milliampere, some of them 1 ampere, and some phone chargers can supply, let's say, 2.2 ampere. So for that reason, this cannot supply enough current to your load, to your bulb, to your motor, whatever you have. And also that's one reason. The second one is that the voltage from use from this will be always 5 volts, the maximum. But when you connect this one, so you can connect it to directly to your power supply, let's say up to 50 volts, up to 100 volts, this can work. So you can connect it to your power supply, regardless of the voltage, up to 100 volts, from 0 to 100 volts, and then from here, this will be connected to the load. So Arduino cannot supply above 5 volts. That's why we are using this, to handle higher voltage and higher current. This is the ground, and this is a positive for the power supply. So you will connect your power supply here. And then these are the two output. One is the plus, it has been labeled, and one is a minus for the load. So you will connect this side. Let's say if this is a resistor, a bulb, or whatever you have. So this will be connected like that. And then for these two wires, the ground, the G and D, will be connected to the ground Arduino, and then the signal will be connected to pin 8 with the code that I have provided. Now here is a demonstration using a motor. As you can see, the current, this is now rotating counterclockwise if I put negative to the negative. So if you want to change the direction of the motor, just switch the wires positive and negative for DC motor. And it can be controlled with this Arduino if you want to control it momentarily, or any other with the program. I just put it here so it was giving it directly 5 volts, but Arduino is turning this on and off. Now I've disconnected it. So if I connect it, you will see whether the light goes on and off, the motor will be controlled. The same way for the high current load, any other DC load that you have, as long as it fits the criteria of amount of current that passes through this, it will be fine. This is now a car electric bulb. I've connected now a current meter to measure the current for this bulb. as you can see here, the current is around 3.6, 3.8 or 3.6 ampere. Now I've connected a 9 ampere load to the switch and I want to see if this can handle it, but of course I know it needs heatsink, but let me just try it. Very hot. So now this is extremely hot, even for a few seconds. Now let me test it with 2 ampere and see how hot this one gets. I'm holding my hand here, making sure. So 2 ampere is very cool now. A little warm, warmed up. So in a few seconds it warmed up. But with this speed of increase in temperature, it shows it might be running cool, because now let's go for 3 amp. Now it's getting hot quickly, I realize, because it needs heatsink. Yes, it got very hot now, slowly. Now I cannot hold it. It's very hot. So let's go for 2.5 amp. So now at 2.5 ampere, still very hot because it was 3 amp. But cooler. So it seems with 2 ampere without the heatsink, this can work continuously. Yes, it's very cool now. Installing a heatsink this way is incorrect, but at least it will have some surface area to dissipate some heat. So I'm gonna attach it here. Let me just apply some silicone here for. Now I have this heatsink. Installed heatsink here because at least it will dissipate some heat. Let me turn it on at 2 amp. So we know it's good. So 2.5 ampere. Now this will dissipate portion of the heat. Not fast, but still it's working. Not hot. So now it's a 3 ampere. This is getting a little warm. So it's now warm, not hot. It's warmer, but this area is very cool, so that's good. Majority of the heat is dissipated here. So overall, we can say that this still, it's working, that's good. This area is cooler and this is warmer. Maybe I should increase it 4. You see the voltage dropped. It's supposed to be 12 volts. It's hot now. Not hot, I can hold it, but yes, now it's getting. Now it's getting very hot. I will leave it for a few seconds. See, it's getting very hot. Now I cannot hold it. So 4 ampere with this tiny heatsink seems unbearable. Now the room temperature is around 25 degrees. So keep that in mind if you are putting it in an environment that is 30 or 40 degrees. This is very minimal for this. So it's very hot now, I cannot hold more than a second. Okay, so 4 ampere will not work, because if it continues like that, it will be very hot. 3 ampere might make it cooler. Yeah, it got cooler now. I can hold it a little longer, but it's getting cooler. So without this heatsink, 2 ampere, and with the heatsink, with this tiny heatsink, 3 ampere. 4 ampere is getting very hot. Maybe you can experiment and put a fan or something to blow. Otherwise, this will not tolerate that, because the design is so bad. We should have enough space on the other side. This would have been enough, but still, this heatsink is not enough for this, so it needs a larger heatsink. Now let's have a look at the voltage change as the current increases, because this is a switch. We want to see when it passes current to the load how much voltage drop occurs here, because according to the data sheet, this is 200 milliohm or 270 milliohm. And if we do some calculation, if we have 5 ampere, so 5 times 0.27, as you can see, we will have 1.23 volts voltage drop. And if we have 10 ampere, 0.2 times 10, 2 volts. So keep that in mind if you have higher current. So let's change this. I'm gonna change it to 5, and this is the voltage, so 9.7. Thank you for watching. This was introduction to this IRF520N MOSFET switch for Arduino. Please make sure to subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos. If you have any questions or comments, please post it at the comment section below. I'll try to answer and reply. Take care.